stayed the night, and having missed the Lewis and Clark Caverns because it was so windy, we're blown us away trying to get to it. So we drove to West Yellowstone and spent a lovely rustic evening in a parking lot in the downtown hotel. However, sleep is sleep, and we were able to make an early start for us. We're now traveling through Yellowstone. This is a beautiful treed area normally that you can see the effects of the fires of 1988, which have burned over acres in this area. Traffic is relatively light at this point. If we continue like this through the day, it'll be pretty moving. We should be able to see at least half, if not all, of the park. The geological and geographical formations here. So, stay tuned when we see something else. Just on a short day.
Looks like somebody punched it.
Yeah.
Right up there.
Typical of the formations in this area, which are volcanic, is this hot water that boils up from the center of the earth. And you can see there, bubbling of it, the steam. If you pan over this way, you can catch the redness, which gives this area the paint pot name.
Yeah.
You can see the flatness. All of these.
Can you imagine when somebody first looked at this place, first pioneers, couldn't you imagine how they feel?
They think evil spirits hit it.
Oh,
100 yards away from the area we just showed you, you can get another idea of the sweep of this volcanic area. And of that geyser off there in the distance blowing away. Better go. Right now, we're down here at what is called the cool. Which is just bubbling like a pot full of porridge. And it has beans for millennials, no doubt.
Mommy? Grandma?
It's as blue can be.
Thank you.
And the steam comes up and gusts. There's an aroma, sometimes of steam, sometimes of minerals. Charlotte said it smelled like corn in the cob. Amazing volcanic area. Makes you feel rather insignificant. Down the other end of the Firehole Lake, just panning backwards, this whole area bathes you in steam. Fogs up the glasses, gums up the lens on the camera. It makes you aware that there are forces at work in this earth that make what men do look small. Small things. I notice over here, not terribly small by himself, but next to all this is Peter Thomas, who asked to have his picture taken. There he is.
Somebody's been talking to me!
Colors, which I hope will show up on this. This is Charlotte, who has agreed to model with me so that you can see the difference between her and out there. It's a very clear view of the fire hole.
We saw lots of paint pots. They were just like blood. It was not a very pretty sight. I'm going to go catch up with the others.
Okay. You're currently looking at Old Faithful, the famous geyser, which is, if you can note, surrounded by other geysers. There are lots of them in the area. And by a gigantic boardwalk.
All along the hill.
We're sitting in some bleachers. There's the dock. And you can see that everything is set for tourists.
Dad, we have my two American pennies. Okay, because Mom said she gave them to you.
There's a very large lodge nearby. Huge parking lots. No faith was going to go one of these days.
Just
discovered something.
What's the wine?
Right down here, a little critter.
What's the wine? What's the wine?
I don't know what he's doing.
Can you get him?
Yep. Charlotte, don't jiggle me, please. Charlotte, what are you doing?
Holding back.
Charlotte, just let go of me, please.
Can you see it, Peter Tom?
There he is! What was that ever big?
White jacket for the people up there?
Where is it? Right in that bare spot there? Come and show me where it is, Peter Tom. Show me where it is. Where to look?
There's a black bear in there somewhere visiting some of those people. You can see them. Congratulations. This is an Old Faithful, but it's a nearby geyser that just erupted. Perspective, there's Old Faithful in the foreground.
This is one thing you can't hurt.
This river flows very near Old Faithful in the whole geyser area.
What happened?
It's beautiful. Especially contrasting with the rock around. This is the large resort that's attached to Old Faithful. And there she is herself. We're still waiting. Faithful only to herself, I think.
Oh, it stopped.
Mom, I'm gonna go in the shop.
Now, dear, what's this false line you gave us?
No, 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 I'm not talking about this. This is, of course, time lapse.
Oh, time lapse.
There she goes, there are many, many false alarms. That's Old Faithful.
Good.
Isn't that incredible?
Look at that. Your last shot was. Here, which is called the cauldron. You can see
considerably closely dissolved in it. Looks like a bowl of porridge. Sure didn't smell like one though. Pretty full of stream down. You can see it's kind of murkiness right there. Sulfur smell. That area down there is as green as lime jello. And bubbles because of steam that rises up to it. I don't know if this camera will pick up.
Trees.
Buffalo have kindly consented to be here for us.
That one there is too close. Okay, stop.
Okay, if I go?
Yeah. And the requisite 100,000 tourists have stopped to look. KOA campground in Custer, South Dakota, not far from Mount Rushmore. As you can see, the household tasks are continuing. This is the best campground we've been in. Unfortunately, we've traveled through some very fine western rugged terrain that I couldn't get on film because I wasn't seated in the proper place in the van. But we have, as you can see, all the comforts of home. And a fine sweep of one of the best KOAs we've been in. We're going this morning to Mount Rushmore, where we'll enjoy seeing the sights. There's Mrs. Ralph, Esquire. There she is. So we'll catch you a little later. Some people have all the luck. They'll grab their grandpa to mount them. I even have this gorgeous walkway up here. I haven't paid a nickel for an entrance or parking or anything. This trip has been a super, super experience. Here's a picture of the wonderfully fragrant Black Hills of South Dakota. Breathtaking beauty on this 5th of July. And we are at the Mount Rushmore visitors area, and you can see a number of people gathered around who are here to view this attraction. The work of one man who began when he was 60 years old to build in the sky a monument to four American presidents, and by so doing to the things the United States stands for. And these people and us are gathered here today to do that. And I just observed for the record that having come through the entire Meech Lake Discord in Canada, from a country torn to pieces, bleeding, it is a great pleasure to be in a nation as disparate as this one and watch people rejoice over their nation, but in the things they hold in common rather than destroying.
Hi, this is Peter. We're coming up through the rocks. You can't hear me too well over the helicopter. What you see here is Mount Rushmore. Right here, there's that. What's that first one? Thomas Jefferson. You can't really get that good in there.
Theodore Roosevelt. There's steep steps.
What's the steps?
I didn't. I know my cold. Once more. So we can get everybody. So I don't want to get everybody up. Spread out. So I'll pass you, please. No, most of the steps are cement. There are some steps that they carved into the clay and stuff. Okay, is everybody coming along?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay, well, let's go ahead and follow me.
Remember, I
know
I can stand right up.
Step here.
You want me to take your jacket?
Well, so far it's no problem.
Oh, but hang on to the rail. Oh, yes, I am. I'm on the other side, I think. On the other side. I saw you.
Be careful that you'll sound the cord. Need to leave for any reason? No? Okay. 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 Does anybody have any questions for me before I start telling you about them? Yes.
Has any of the passageways here had to be made bigger or be blocked through? Or?
In the ceiling area, they tried not to dig into it. The spots that they dug down into were the floor, mostly. They tried not to dig into the sides or anything else, just into the floor.
Okay. Is there any spiders in here?
No, there's no spiders or anything.
There's no animals in here. It's just
someone's coming.
No, there's no animals or anything.
It's just all rock?
Yes, it's all rock, limestone. And clay. There's no animals.
Nope.
No. People are there?
Yep. Are there any other questions?
How deep are we right now?
Right now we're about approximately 100 foot from the surface. The lowest point will be 180 to 200 foot below the surface. That'll be about two rooms from here. Are there any other questions?
Okay,
well, the reason that they call this the post office is because the kids of Hayward. Well, the kids of Hayward, when they made it to this point, they're amazed that they made it this far, so they scratch their names and initials in the rock. Some of what you do when you write a postcard, you put your name and your address. Well, that's what they did in the ceiling. You look like right up above this gentleman here. You see some of those initials? Right up over here.
Right there.
Yeah, there's some back in here. A couple up in here. Back behind this gentleman. People on the lower flight, you can see right up here, some initials also. In 1964, approximately, they did pass a federal law to protect all the caves in the Black Hills. It's approximately a $500 fine and or 90 days in jail if you're caught vandalizing the caves in a sort of way, such as borrowing of formations. Are there any questions before we start out again? 3 years ago, we did have a gentleman break up a large stalactite. He stuck it in his pocket. One of the people at the back of the tour saw that. The gentleman... As the gentleman left, they didn't quite catch him. We chased him down. We caught him at Oh, we got some people. Hello, please.
Oh, let's sit up.
Is this everybody?
We got a few more going on.
Oh, okay, I see him. Which is somewhat blocked off by this rubble pile, which you can see right back in here. The reason for this rubble pile is because of a supposed tremor or earthquake 20,000 years ago. During that earthquake, there was quite a little bit of damage caused, but there was some beauty. Some passageways, or some unique passageways, were opened up. I'll point those out to you on the back portion. The reason for all these formations around us and on top of us is because there is a meadow directly above us. As water collects on that meadow, it starts to run down through the layers of rock, clay, calcites and stuff, calcite minerals, and then deposits the calcite minerals into the ceiling, the little ringlets. Over centuries, the ringlets will multiply, and you have the first stage of stalactite. It's called a soda straw. You look right over here, you can see one of those. Get down here.
Coming up here. Turn it off.
we're just at the Rushmore Cave. Going down now. You're going up. Aerial railway. And behind me, Trevor and Peter. We're going to and wanted to ride in the room. So here we go up through the cut. Wonder what we'll see when we get to the top. Black Hills. Beautiful. Extraordinary. South Dakota Black Hills, very famous.
I am chicken!
The top of a cable car ride. We get a breathtaking view of the Black Hills. And, Charlotte, where did you go?
Right here.
Oh, there you are. Breathtaking view of Charlotte. And then, shooting into the sun, I don't know how much good this will do. Final glimpse of Rushmore. Trying to get it in there so that the backlight doesn't affect it. The sculpture that says a lot about what the United States is all about. Exquisitely beautiful place.
We have here, so we're on the cable cars, close to Charlotte. Charlotte is riding with little girl, lady. They're coming down a long way. This is for Mom and Grandma and Grandpa. We're on the second from the front. We have got lots of scenery. Helicopters going around every now and then. Our father? Dad? Say hi.
Hi, I'm not sure you'll get me that close, son.
I'm far back.
Well, it doesn't matter.
His course, and it comes complete with badminton court, as you can see. Zippy game, complete with cheering sound.
No way, Kiki.
You'll call me the fastest man in the
world. Poor Grandpa. He is being taken advantage of. As always, we have Grandma. There she is. She was cleaning up after breakfast. This is our kitchen. The door to outside. It's a beautiful spot that God has provided for us. Whoops, we've lost the Grandpa. Let's go around and see where he went. There's Peter, the mad badminton player. And over here is Grandpa.
They don't come in fastest.
There, you missed it, Peter.
He's standing there.
And over here we have Charlotte. And this is our living room. Yes, honey.
Hello.
There's our living room. Charlotte, why don't you go down and show us your bedroom?
Hey, show us, Martha.
This is Charlotte's bedroom. Down here. two beds, lovely window looking outside.
Her
closet, and there she has a little note on her door that says,
"Do not disturb this room."
No, I'm not.
Do not disturb this room. She got an idea for a note like that. And down the hall here, we have another bedroom, and this is for Peter Thomas. It has a captain's bed and a bed for a friend if a friend came. He's made a friend, but his friend has not stayed overnight. Char, how about showing us Grandma's and Grandpa's bedroom? There's one washroom. There's another one down the other end of the hallway. It has a washer and dryer. And this is Grandma's and Grandpa's bedroom.
This looks like a little shower here, but it's a purse place.
Yeah. This is the end of the house, and then this is the bedroom for Peter and Sharon. Again, at the end of the house. So it is a lovely place for us to stay. This is outside the back of the house, and we have a clothesline and apple tree. We had a badminton net, but we just discovered it disappeared. And there's a radio station over there. And I don't think you can see it on the film, but there are two bunnies hopping around over there in the grass. Last night when we were looking out this window, there were three huge deer that came grazing across.
What happened?
Wonderful. The house. Down there's a little bunny. Just right up here beside the sidewalk. There he goes, hippity hopping away. And this is our view from where we stand. There's the mountains. You can see the outline of them a bit. There's a lot of haze and fog up there. It's been quite a foggy morning. It gives you an idea of where we are. On the top of a little hill. Evergreens. It's a beautiful spot. Morning. This is Friday morning. We are in Minot with Peter Thomas. There's Grandma, Grandpa, and Charlotte. And where's Daddy? I can't find him. We are in Minot, North Dakota, having breakfast. And we're heading up to St. Lazare today.
I got my sand up yesterday.
Whoops. Where are you, Char?
I got the sand up.
Come on out and show us. Look at that.
Becky isn't going to like it.
Whoa. They're not really spandex. They're bicycle pants.
Two different shoes that turn out to look good together.
Hey, do you know what we got? Our place box of yellow.
And two drinking boxes and
glasses. What? We got drinking boxes? Whoa. We got drinking boxes?
Yeah, those bottles.
And there are the grandparents.
Hold on, Mommy. We are going to show you the wonderful world of boxes.
And I don't know where Pete went. But here we are.
Here's mine.
Here's mine.
And there's Peter Thomas.
Here's yours.
And here's mine.
And there's Charlotte's. Are you going to say something, Peter Ralph? You?
You like my new shorts.
Excuse me, Peter Thomas, let me see Daddy's shorts. Wow. Whoever bought you those must really love you.
Yes.
Don't break.
Nice knees.
Don't say things you don't mean.
Whoever bought them can't read, however. Because the tag says, high tight swimwear and wash to remove excess dye before wearing. So if the seat turns gray today, it's not my fault.
No.
It is your fault.
Watch out there, sunshine. And isn't he gorgeous? And there's the grandma and the grandpa. Now they haven't said much of anything yet.
Too busy eating.
Too busy eating. This
greetings
is our
and salutation.
This
and
is
all
our
that sort of jazz.
our table laden with all the breakfast delicacies. Teapots.
Oh no.
Shave kits.
Could you tell them where we are, dear?
Yes, I told them we were in Minot, North Dakota, ready to go into St. Lazare, Manitoba.
After we do some more shopping.
It's a beautiful day, windy, sunny, and warm. It's our neighbors. And there's the highway. It's the same KOA we stayed at last year on the way to Hamilton. We are at Baraka Valley, and the horseback riding expedition is about to begin. Here we're having an explanation of these horses. Thomas. Go careful, Daddy. I have a little colt who's not sure that it likes this idea at all. Hang on there, Daddy. Here we have Charlotte with her type of animal. Where did the dog go? There we are. And all these little children. And there's my little Charlotte. And there we have. You guys will be on a ride for an hour, they say.
Horse by herself. No. So I'm not going to let her take off on that.
What a nice animal thing.
Yeah. My husband and I like Pritchett better than the Clydesdale. And we know the Anderson Bound and Verdon who trained in. Actually, they're smaller.
Are you?
There we are.
Peter's mom?
Yes, I'm Peter's mom and Peter's wife.
Oh, I see. Peter.
Yeah. Here we are.
That's what I was telling my...
On our way. Not sure. Oh, going over that way. There we are. A little bit of perspective here. Oh, I thought they were going.
They'll
must always be up in the head.
There they go. Where's Peter Thomas? There he is. This is Wednesday at the camp. Grandpa just got up from a snooze. It will soon be supper time. And they're just having a little conversation. This is the hillside.
Here's
the other side of the valley.
Are you videotaping them?
There's the house, there's the barn. There's Travis with my binoculars. This is the house where we live. That's Charlotte's room up there.
Are you just,
This is Travis. Travis, what is your last name?
Lowen.
And where do you live, Travis?
Mackenzie's.
At Mackenzie's?
Mm-hmm.
And what town is this near? Is it near St. Lazare?
St. Lazare.
In Manitoba.
Manitoba.
And this is Baraka Valley Camp.
Yeah.
Travis is about 6 years old.
Seven,
I'm sorry. And Travis is a friend of mine.
Yeah.
Bye, Travis.
Bye.
Sharon? This is working just fine. That's because you had the upper panel exposed. I'll show you. First of all, let's take a picture of Grandma and Grandpa. Then we'll get a picture of Travis. I can see you waving your hand up there, Travis. If you go over near Peter, I'll take a picture of you. Where are you? Where'd you go? Oh, there you go. Now, this is Travis. He lives here. Okay, here he comes. See that? I'll do a wide angle. Well, I can't see him anymore.
Get to me, Dad.
Yeah, I got you. There he goes back there.
Grandma has ripped the ligament.
What?
So I'm making her walk your stick with rugged ankle and climbing downhill. What? Oh. Oh. Shrimp, I'm dulling your knife real nice.
You're not ticklish, are you, Travis?
Yeah.
No, you're not.
Yeah.
That scene sort of speaks for itself.
He's on the ground.
You can see some of the beautiful valley around Baraka Valley Ranch Camp. One of the houses and over there in the distance. Eugene's house. And a mud puddle. Travis is about to fall into it. You can see the wonderful shades of green.
You know, what do you think the settlers did?
That make up the valley.
Sandpaper.
And the
what? To do what you're doing.
You can't see it from here, but the Assiniboine River that winds through it. Absolutely lovely.
Bark off!
Well, you take a handful of sand and try it, and you'll see.
It's rained pretty heavily, and so the green has been subdued just a little.
to get on the video. Think about it. Get in line and think about it. You don't have to say yes.
I guess Peter Thomas feels somewhat humiliated to be walked around, but will. That's because you've been on trail rides all week. But who likes horses so much that he'll do anything to get on horseback?
Charlotte?
Unfortunately, I came too late to get some
She shook the saddle and she still fell off.
You gonna ride here? No.
No, no, I'm different than
that. Maybe. I'll think about it.
You want a wild horse?
But this proves you actually really did it, right? Yeah. And this horse has six legs.
He likes to do it by himself. Yeah. No, he doesn't. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Jonathan is back on again.
Okay, is your horse? Allison is ready to go. While we're at it, we'll check it out and see where Jonathan's got to.
Ethan!
All by yourself, huh?
I believe that's him right there.
Well, I thought he was just walking in front of it.
Hey, did you ever encounter?
No, no, okay. Let's go to the back of the line.
No, you can if you want to turn. Go ahead.
No, it's okay.
Oh, yeah? Right.
Here, moi.
Come on down, Jonathan.
Trying to do that, huh, Joshua?
Okay.
Hi, Miles. Oh.
Another run.
Oh,
I go back for him. As soon as they turn 12, I go back for him. And I hit the hook. You
know, put that down and don't do it again.
On your way.
She's taking a shot. Ethan just took off. And there's Allison.
Yeah, you just.
Ethan's right there. He's got a little colt.
Are you going to know what's going on?
Ethan's. Hey, dear, look at that. He's
on. I'm one. One.
That's fair enough.
Are you trying to convince her to go on?
Yeah, I should have seen that thing.
Jonathan,
that's a cat.
something like that.
Huh?
Wait.
All right. Have all of the children been on once?
Okay, now some are more so than others.
There's Allison.
Yeah, they've been on. Do you want to ask?
Here's Ethan. And nobody's leading him this time. He's doing his own job.
That's why.
He's
a little nervous.
She's a brave girl. She walks right behind the horse. Like a stupid nerd. Hmm.
What's this?
She walks right behind the horse, like what a nerdhead.
Yeah, they're all by himself.
Yeah, I'd be petrified if he could kick up his leg and smack him in the face.
It's not worse. Lift up its tail.
Go ahead. Sit down, don't step for a door.
Noivus.
What's this?
You? In the middle.
It's who I met.
Last not seen, you have not heard.
Put them both on one.
That's Melody, too. So.
I fell off.
I was good on it.
Anybody who wants to see pink. There she is. Right up. There's Melody. Okay.
Hi, Melody.
Listen, isn't that a picture? I'll set him to buckle. Where? Where's Holly?
Mommy's
on the horse.
Mom!
How'd you hear, Mom?
We'll find another. Here we have Holly. Horse-bound Holly. Horse-born Holly.
Just a little something for the Canadian Alliance.
Teenage Holly.
Holly.
Is there any adolescent or adult that hasn't ridden yet?
Quiet,
that wants to.
Nathan, Mama's having trouble.
Oh, yeah.
You couldn't get the world going.
The worst they could do to you girls is just let them go, you know?
Considerably ahead of the game.
Mrs. Rock?
Oh, I'm all
grandma.
She
was on Indiana Jones.
Whoa. Always game for something new.
Okay. Hey, Grandma, big smile. Yay! Come on, back to me if I fall.
No speeding, Grandma. Watch it. Only left foot, Grandma.
Go on, Did you have a good ride?
It's okay. Yeah. It's here, I think. Oh,
Bernie.
Okay.
Full leg, Bernie.
Holly in the foreground, Sharon in the background. Melody and Grandma. Would you believe it?
I whistled with breath before.
I think
other kids are behind me. I'll go on, Dad. I know, but if you let me go pretty up.
Mommy.
You have to
It's fun, eh?
Yeah.
Dad. Come on, Dan, your turn.
Yeah, come on, Daddy.
Horse, come on, Dan.
Oh, you're going to get on.
Oh, great.
Boy.
Cowboy Dan. Huh? What did it do? I just said, good girl, good girl.
Damn. What a cowboy boots for, anyway.
That's too bad, yeah. Then that would have been sort of like Bonanza, you know?
I don't know. Mom, are you
what time is it?
There she goes. Reeboks were made for riding horses.
Okay, you're welcome. Any other adult or adolescent?
Well, I guess I got it.
Mother.
Grandma.
Grandma.
There.
I'm not in line, Dad.
More adults riding children.
Congratulations, Mom.
I did.
Yes.
Did you get on the ride or did you get off
the ride? No, it doesn't.
Your hair is in the clouds. Does it
hurt, Grandma?
Against the hole or
something. No, you're turning one. I did it again.
Oh, well. Okay.
That's okay. When they show, we're gonna run a tape of the Bonanza theme. We got the three of you lined up across there.
Yeah. More dignified.
Why don't we stand in line? I'll stand with you. And then if you decide you can, and if you decide not to, you don't have to. Okay?
You're
going to
have to. There he goes. Yeah. Here comes Holly in hot pursuit. He's their third lap.
I haven't done it
for a while. That's really good. Okay. Yep, you're there.
Pretty good fun, eh?
You got it out of the park.
This is a good horse for
that. She's got a smile just like this. Just like I remember her.
I know how. You go like this and you kind of tap your thing.
Actually, even though I wasn't in it, you can tell it was something you probably
know. Oh, there's an ant.
Sometimes. I'm gonna go.
How long are you gonna do this for?
Right. That's what I was teasing you with. Here, you can have it. You can keep me in arms. See, we took them 3 hours. You're a good boy. Like, without
writing this, you can just have a coach. We're going to like.
Sometimes it's not. Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
Cassidy smile on his face.
The other horse I rode so in cool. In the past year, so I people just know I think it's best.
There he is.
You don't look like a person.
No.
Daddy. Well, Philip, his horse seems to want to get a little steam up.
He wants you to get on the horse or something.
That's the truth.
Then
I lose it
again.
Daddy,
you
want
to
do
I want, but I don't want.
Oh, yeah,
hey, Dad.
Dad. Are you calling me, Charlotte?
Look.
I can't look right now, sweetheart.
Bring it down.
Do a trick for us.
14.
Okay, count out 14.
1, 2, 3,
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10,
11, 12, 13, 14.
These are cards.
Okay, now count out 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
How many cards
this
you
got one
left?
Is a 2.
Ooh,
yes!
Yeah,
just stand up and see if we can feel the difference.
Want me to tell you how I did that? Yeah, tell us.
Okay, what you do is you put down. You put down. Okay, say you put down this 4, 5,
six, seven, eight, nine, ten, jack, king, okay?
Okay.
And then I keep doing that until I run out of cards and say I left out with one card, right?
Yeah.
Then then after that I flip over.
See, now I'm pressing. This is how hard I was pressing the other one.
Greg, what do I do after I put this? Greg, what do I do after I put this card down? After, because I have that card.
Okay, there's your stack of cards.
That's the ace.
There's another pack.
You've turned them all over though.
What she
did. Okay, I'll just do the trick over again so you guys can see it all. Okay. I'm going to do it over for you so you actually, like,
Relax.
Okay. First of all, you go, okay, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, jack, king, queen. So you've got a pile right there. Then you go, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, jack, king, queen. And there's another pile. Then you go, okay, 8, 9, 10, jack, king, queen. There's another pile. Jack. Okay, you keep doing that until you run out of cards.
Yeah.
So we'll just do that.
Yeah, actually, you shouldn't use the jack, queen, king. You just put it aside and start with the next card. Okay. Use it. Make sure you pick it up after.
Okay. Okay. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Oh. 9, 10, 10, jack, king, queen. There's another pile. Right there. Three cards left. So I put them in that pile right here. It's here. And then I take away two piles.
You
okay,
gotta go now.
Okay, so I add that up. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 16. Okay, that's 16. Now I count out 16 from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 11, 12.
How do you do this 14, trick, Charlotte?
15, 16, 16, 16. Okay.
Okay, we're gonna wait till she's done shuffling.
The 16 pile, you missed one, Charlotte.
What, 3 days later?
The big pile.
I didn't do it right.
Just kidding.
Well, miscounting it is one thing, but I think you got the trick, though.
Not work, but that's okay.
Okay, so that means 5. So
until Charlotte gets back in the right place.
Okay, I'll have to do it again.
Goodbye.
9, 10, jack, king, queen. So there's a pile, okay?
Right there.
Okay, here's 8, 9, 10, jack, king, queen. There's another pile. Okay, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, jack, king, queen. Another pile. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, jack, king, queen.
Man, that focusing is fast.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, jack, king, queen. There's a pile. Okay. I don't need these cards right now. Okay, next, what we do is we take away two of these piles. There, they're gone. They're with this. Then I flip over two of these, okay? This. Okay, mm-hmm. Add that up, 7, 8, 9, so I have to count out 9 from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, I've got 9 right there. Now I have to count out 10. 1, 2, 3, 4,
that's
five,
the wrong
six,
date.
7, 8, 9, 10. Here's 10. Okay, this is our 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is an 8. Ta-da! There you go.
How'd you do that?
We'll teach you how when you have the camcorder on.
No, we want to know on the camcorder.
Okay. Want me to do it again?
Yeah.
Okay.
No, not the camcorder.
Sure. Okay, bye.
Very nice dog, very stupid dog. Nice day out. This is on the Fowl Supper. Mom and Dad have gone to the Fowl Supper. I'm just taping this for a surprise for them. Amy's coming home, but she's not home yet. Yeah, those are nice, aren't they? What's the date? Hi, Amy, say something. Say something, Amy.
Hi.
You are on Totally Hidden Video. Grace is freaking. Where is he?
Make a phone call for
your
mouth and I'm ready to talk to you, okay?
Great.
Goodbye. Oh, I know what's
the matter. What?
We are here on a Saturday morning, a Saturday night. I am George McClaw, and this is Charlotte the Great. She is a great rescuer. She rescues people. Her last rescue was rescuing Amy Grant. This is a live broadcast. Tune in after these messages.
This is great. You see these poles? When they just go great right here, or right here, or right here, right now you can buy that Sears for only $4.99. You got it, only $4.99. Thank you.
We're back here. So, Charlotte, I hear that last rescue was really great and is known all over the world. Is that true?
Yes, it is very true.
Okay. What was this rescue that you so miraculously did?
Well, it was the day of Amy Grant's concert, and this mad guy wrapped her up and took her away.
Okay. It was at an Amy Grant concert. Was this before or after the show?
It was right in the middle of it.
So a guy walked out in the middle of the stage, grabbed her, and ran away.
Yes, that's very true.
Okay. I would like to know what you did. Give me all the details.
Well, when I saw that happen, I myself knew that I was a great rescuer. And so I went... I got the license plate of the man's car, and I phoned the police. The police said they couldn't do anything, so I myself had to do the rescue. So I went to Amy Grant's house. She wasn't there. I thought she would be there because she could get away, but she wasn't there, so I...
Okay, I have to interrupt you now for a commercial. RMP. Now, where were you?
I was at, when I was gonna go to the madman's house. And I saw Amy Grant tied up with the mouthpiece in her mouth, and she was screaming and yelling and kicking like a mad girl.
How could she scream if there was a piece of cloth in her mouth?
She was trying to scream. She was going something like that.
So far, you were at an Amy Grant concert. Amy Grant was there in the middle of the show. A guy walked out, picked up her, wrapped her up, shoved her in the back of his 48 Chevy, hit the throttle, spun off to his house. You went to Amy Grant's house thinking she'd be there. She wasn't. So you went to his house because the police said they couldn't do anything. You found her there, gay and tied up, to a chair, trying to scream?
Yes.
Okay, what did you feel like when you saw her?
I felt this is one of my worst cases that I've ever solved, and I was trying to think of what to do.
That's very interesting. Just what did you do?
Well, I tried to get in, but the man wouldn't let me in, so when it was quite dark out and it wasn't very late, I snuck in the house because he left his back door open. I snuck in the house and I...
Just how dark was this?
It was about pitch black. I couldn't see very well, but I just sort of felt my way around.
You had your trusty, your trusty flashlight there.
Yes, I did.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is the flashlight she had. It works, but I understand that when she went in, the door creaked shut and hit her hand. The flashlight went smashed up in a whole bunch of little pieces. It's repaired now. And he thought he saw, heard something. So he went over and to see what it was, and she drop-kicked him. Is that true?
Yes, that is true.
Where did you learn karate?
When I was a teenager, about 15, I took karate lessons at a school just because I was going to become a detective.
Yes, so that comes in handy in a lot of your cases, I understand.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay. We've got to take time for another commercial break. We'll see you back at W5MP. Goodbye. WMP, we're the one. Thank you. This is Peter Giggle Goggle, and this is Charlotte Dropkicker. We are, we've changed our names because we couldn't remember our old ones. And Amy Grant, so far, is still been gigged and everything. Go on with your story.
Well, when I kicked him, he fell down unconscious, and he was unconscious for about an hour, which gave me just enough time to get Amy Grant out.
Okay, what did you do as soon as you got Amy Grant out?
Well, I asked her a few questions like, how come he took you there, or...
He was trying to steal the show, was he not?
Yeah.
Okay. Did he chase you at all?
No, he did not chase me.
Where is he now? In jail, or have you told
him? Well, they haven't quite caught him yet, but the police are on the road.
So he skipped town? He skipped town.
Well, sort of, yeah.
How far did he go?
I'm not quite sure of that right now.
just had a bulletin. He has gone right through to New York. They have just caught him. He is behind bars. And we want to thank you very much, Charlotte Dropkick. WMP, whatever. We're no one. This is Peter signing off for WMP, whatever. You're the one. Goodbye and good night, folks. WPMPS, you're the one.
Okay, hello, this is Charlotte Ralph, and we are here interviewing Peter Thomas. Peter, I believe I understand that you took, that you have saw a lot of breaking in people's houses. I believe one time you saw some of that happen. Tell me the story.
Well, we were back, I say it was about 5 years ago. I was driving down this street. I hadn't become a detective yet. There was a guy there, had a beard on, glasses, sunglasses. He didn't look like he was doing too much. Then I saw him take out a crowbar and break the lock. That got my suspicions up. So I pretended I had blown a tire. I got out and got my spare tire up. But instead of jacking the car up and putting it on, I sat there and looked underneath the car at him. He went in. I saw him take stuff. He had a van. I believe it was an old Ryder truck. And it had moving spray painted across the sky side, but he did not have his company's coat on it. So I was just watching, and all of a sudden some police cars came up and screeched to a stop, and they got on the loudspeaker and said, "Come out with your hands up, you're under arrest." And he yelled out, "I've got hostages, don't shoot, give me a car with a full tank of gas, and let me out of here." So
sorry, just a minute, we have to excuse you for a commercial break. Okay, we're back on WCMP. This is Peter.
Yes, as I was saying, the police... This went on for about 2 or 3 hours, and the police finally said, "Okay, we'll give you a car." So I offered my car, knowing that it did not have a full tank of gas, and it would not do past 80 kilometers an hour. It was an old, I'd say, what was it again? It was a Dodge Colt Blue, and it couldn't do past 80 kilometers an hour. So he got in there. He started it up, and he nailed the throttle to the floor. He had all the hostages in the back of his car, and we could see he had a Uzi machine gun. It was really scary. He nailed the throttle to the floor, and my engine blew. He got out and started running. The police started shooting, and I yelled, "Stop!" So they stopped, and I ran around to the side of the house, and there was a shortcut the block. He was running around the block. I jumped out on him. All the kids were still in the car. He had knocked him unconscious somehow. It's a blunt instrument. I jumped out and grabbed him by the neck, and I wrestled him to the floor. Me and my son did a lot of wrestling. We had fun that way. And so I wrestled him down.
It's about a lot of learning though too. Right?
And I pinned his arms against his back, and the police all came running up, put handcuffs on him, and I got a reward of $4,000. And also the people who had things stolen invited me over for a steak dinner.
We're going to excuse you for right now, because we've got more commercial breaks. We're back on WCMP. This is Peter. Back to your story.
Actually, that's all that really happened.
Okay, well then I have a few questions to ask you. Why, when did, is that when you decided to be a detective?
Yes, it was. I sat a day after, well, a couple of days after, I think it was about a week. I was sitting down, and I was gonna go to university, and I had no idea what I wanted to be. All of a sudden, it hit me on the head right between the eyes. And I want to be a detective and help a whole bunch of people. So that brought me to what I am today. I am not exactly like Sherlock Holmes, but I did my duty.
Well, have you ever solved any more natural cases?
Yes, quite a few. That was about 5 years ago, I'd say. And I always have them. One time in a coffee shop, it was a Chinese coffee shop, I was eating my rice, and they gave me a fortune cookie, and I opened it up, and a message fell into my lap. And I was talking to this girl who wanted to become a detective, and I said, well, you know, detective's job is pretty hard. Cases don't just go and fall into your lap. I picked up the piece of paper, and it said, help, I'm a prisoner in a fortune cookie factory. And I said, what? And she goes, whoa, what? And I go, the keys just fell right into my lap.
That's funny. Okay, have you ever almost been, like, risked your life to do any of these cases?
Yes, just a couple weeks ago, there was armed robbery at the second local bank in Regina. I had no guns, and the guy who was stealing had hostages again, and he had a machine gun. And that sort of put a damper on our relationship.
Okay, that's all for today. Bye-bye. WCMP, that's us!
All right, that's a wrap, folks!
Now where's our fade on this thing?
Here we go. Bye.
That's a wrap, folks. I hope you can see that. Goodbye. Is there a light going on and off?
Yeah, I love them, but they're awful materials.
See that?
Yeah.
The light bulb in there?
You know what?
No, it would be in the middle. It wouldn't be in the middle.
Yeah. No, these are old.
Where are these ones?
Where the used to be going?
Oh, no, I got angel hair on my
teeth.
Are they?
Mom, why don't these ones work?
They don't? I don't know, honey. They're just old.
Honey, don't break.
Don't try.
No, just watch. Just look.
Oh, here. Don't get it.
Kind of
what?
The ones that
I need an extra
you sort of go, well, okay, we've had these before, so we'll have them.
Yeah, that's exactly
right. Not because they're new and one.
No. Sorry. I'm walking across the
camera. Everything that I have, everything that we own is made in Taiwan.
That's cute.
The cheap labor.
Does that one work?
So here we are at Christmas under the rug.
Under the rug.
Mental block.
This party is
supposed to be under the rug.
Yeah. Yeah. Black or white, or all we've got is a black or white or a cream.
I think that's in the rug.
I'm trying to do next.
And there's more bulbs here, so I don't want to try some more bulbs.
Same color?
Yeah.
You got lots of red on here.
Yeah. I drink every 4 hours this semester.
year. Well, we wanted to have this in the second register of every year.
Do you want to have this lot, but yeah,
the roads are pumped on one spot in Castle.
And then I...
Wait,
they flashed on.
Yeah, once you replace that one flash...
I don't know, it's punching everything. My other dog.
Who is the dog that you swung?
It's starting to bother him. He let go. Yeah, he said, I guess that's right.
To get me in focus.
It's mother's first, and I work there for like, doesn't bring you.
Just hang on.
No, open it.
Open it?
Yeah.
Oh, all right.
I will show you how that works. Does anybody else have any more questions?
Name the paper. Green Christmas.
This is a candle holder. This side of the candle.
Mint.
Oh, that is neat. Oh.
Well, it depends.
This is part of the day.
Dad, you left a price sticker.
Gary, I knew you were.
You did?
I didn't get that for you.
Thanks for sharing.
Okay, this is called a delicate opening present.
What is that? He received his the last time. He was holding the whole chart.
And then he and Charlotte
walked into his room with a pile of paper.
What about mine?
I got one for the family.
Really?
This red.
An actual account of ship called the Foundation Crackle, which is a salvage tug that Kevin Newcomb on. And he's written this one, and also the other one, the surface spoils.
We have to order them right away.
He's funny. He's also, he's just a constant.
Well, 24 is the end.
Whoa, 24 is the end.
And then, once you're in that area, dial up the number and talk to the
No, they don't have one of those receivers.
No, you can dial on the phone.
Oh, I see. Really? Well, that's nice.
Dad, this is making funny noises.
He called me at home to let me know he was coming home.
Are we in jail?
Is that right? So what did you say?
Do you have to tune to that?
Lyle, is that?
That's a good one to tune to.
So who was that just talking in there?
There's a couple of guys in town.
This is in town. First celebration in
that guy was talking there live because he's blind.
Mimi?
So they're just talking together?
Yep. This guy manages a McDonald's or something. I don't know what he does. He goes.
Everybody give us a
favor.
We don't have a clue
anymore. Okay, so let us come together. Pray to the
us so all the people on the earth can hear our praise. Let us come together, praise the name of Jesus, so all the people on the earth can hear our praise.
Yeah.
Joy is like a fountain, raining down upon us. Joy is like a golden crown. Let us come together, praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Do you like B?
Yeah.
C is best.
Bye.